Great catch and run after the ball. Way to protect the ball. Watch how he wraps his hands around the end of this one, Charles.
And Tony is a defender, and when you're getting ready for a team like this, you probably don't treat Theo Riddick as a running back in your game plan, do you? You treat him more as a wide receiver, don't you?
Absolutely.
And this is what he does best. Run routes, catch the ball in open space, and turn it into first downs.
Riddick is closing in on the all-time Lions franchise record for receiving yards in a season. Here at Abdullah. All right. Are the Panthers still undefeated? How about it, Mike Hill?
And the answer is no. Down by 7 here with just over a minute left. Cam Newton stripped by Vic Beasley. Adrian Claiborne gets the recovery. And the 72 Dolphins will go ahead and light up those cigars. No undefeated team this season. 20-13, the final. Back to you guys.
Although I don't know if Don Shula's lighting a cigar.
Don Shula won't be. I think Mercury Morris will be cracking up the champagne and the whole day. He can't wait. But Don Shula won't be because his son Mike is the offensive coordinator for the Carolina.
That's right. And he told us that the AL came with him.
Right. But he's still got a smile.
There's no smile deep inside yet. Abdullah slips by Bean, wrapped up in the 19-yard line. I'm going to finish the thing real quick, though, about him. You think about where the 49ers were when Bolden made the decision to leave the Baltimore Ravens. The Ravens had beat the 49ers a year before in the Super Bowl.
Yes.
And then he decides, you know what? That 49er team's pretty good. They got a sighted quarterback, right?
Yep.
In Colin Kaepernick. They've got a great head coach. Their franchise on the comp
defense.
And here we are 3 years later. And here they've gone from a title game to 8-8 to on their way to their 11th loss. He got his first career catch and his first career game. What a game for a debut, September the 7th, 03, then as a Cardinal. 10 receptions, still a career high
217
and 2 touchdowns. This may surprise some of you, the number of games it has taken Bolden to get to 1,000 receptions and how it compares to others, and there are only 12 others that have reached that figure in their career. Third and 2, Stafford went for the first down. In the number of games to get to a thousand. How about fifth fewest games?
That's serious company right there, too.
You better believe that. Hall of Fame, Hall of Fame, Hall of Fame, Hall of Fame.
We got one in, right? Jerry Rice is already in, correct? Everyone else is going at some point. But how'd you like to be a Hall of Fame voter trying to figure out all these receivers that are going to go in? Because the number explosion...
You're
has
right.
Really, really skewed a lot of things about what's
point.
A Hall of Famer and what's not. But all those guys, I think, played at a Hall of Fame level.
Well, Rice is the only one on that list that was not in the quote-unquote entire career of the passing game. Some might argue when you have Jerry Rice, that's why it didn't.
That's why it changed. Without a doubt.
Flag down, ball inside the 5-yard line after the carry.
Offensive it's coming back. 10-yard penalty, be first down.
So that's Larry Warford getting another penalty. But truthfully, this is the time now as we take a look at Detroit. This is where, as an offensive lineman, with the change in coaches, remember they let Jeremiah Washburn, their offensive line coach, go, as well as Joe Lombardi, the offensive coordinator. Ron Prince moved from tight ends to take over the offensive line. Tony talked about this at our meeting last. You got to change mentality, too. They're used to standing back and pass protecting. Jim Bob Cooter and Ron Prince want them firing off and run blocking. Here's a great time of the game to get more reps in as a running team.
Yeah, that's the whole thing. You know, they talk about muscle memory in any sport. You know, when you're an offensive lineman, the only thing that you're doing is going backwards, backwards, backwards every week, you know, all of a sudden you become, you know, a person going backwards. You know, when you come out, you can go and establish the run and hit somebody. Come out and be the hammer instead of the nail all the time. I just think offensive linemen want that. They want to set a precedence. They want to show that they're aggressive to the defensive linemen. They don't want them attacking them all the time. I think that's where the run game helps you in a game like this, when you're trying to go and get first downs with, you know, the ball on the ground, and you can work that clock.
Second down, Stafford to throw it down the middle, and there's Johnson inside the five to the one. The ball is loose. No, they're saying it's down. The ball is down. The ground calls a fumble. Johnson took a big hit, and that will put him very close to the 100-yard mark receiving on the day.
Let's see if he completes the process of the catch, because that really came into our lexicon with the Calvin Johnson rule. Didn't you do that game, Tom?
I did. That was in Chicago.
The receiver did not maintain possession when he hit the ground. It's an incomplete pass. It was third and 20 at the 36-yard line.
Charles, would you like to leave the money here?
I'll just hand you my wallet now. Here you go.
I don't understand that.
Take it.
Please reset the game clock to 2 minutes.
Mike, what could it possibly be? Could it be, could the ball right there where it's moving? Is that possibly why they say it's not a catch?
I really think what they determined is that he was going to the ground and was not a receiver on his feet. That's the first question that has to be asked, you know. And to me, this is that one where he has actually got both feet on the ground with control and is turned up field. So I would have liked it, since it was ruled a catch
on the field
contact, I think they'd have been wiser to stay with it, because there's clearly an element of doubt, but not enough to me to change.
Hey, Mike, before we let you go, I want to ask your opinion on this, because you're so dialed in, maybe more than anybody in the game of football today. There has been so much talk. Pivotal moments going back to last year in the playoffs. It was talked a little bit about this year and some things sort of, you know, carved up here and trimmed up there. Do you think this whole definition of a catch will be looked at again by the rules committee / ownership this upcoming offseason?
Well, I mean, they formed a committee to look at it now. There's some catch players being thrashed on it. An ex-official, Tom Finkins, on it. But they're going to talk about it again for the fifth straight year. So I'm not so sure what's going to come out of it. The thing is, I will say that it's a very, very small amount of plays that get to this level where you get confused. And I think that right now, I kind of get most of it, except the upfront decision of trying to decide whether a receiver is on his feet or whether he's going to the ground. And maybe they can look at that element and try to get some more clarity there.
Okay. Thanks, Mike. Thanks, as always.
And that's going to be tough, because that play we just saw, I'm not sure what more you do than take two steps and get tackled and call on your feet. That's why I'm confused.
That makes two of us.
Well, you wouldn't want to, you know, try to make a living betting against the opinion of Mike Pereira, nor would you want to make a living betting against the New England Patriots. The Jets have just scored a touchdown in overtime. Four-yard field goal try, and it is good by Kramer to make it 32-17. We mentioned a moment ago that Riddick was knocking on the door of the Lions' single-season franchise record for receiving yards by a running back.